to make a Record My Desktop video. We are using an application called gtk-recordMyDesktop. I've tried several different ones, and this is the one I like the best. I use it on two different computers. One is a netbook that has Jolly Cloud on it. That's an operating system that works with desktops and laptops, but it's really great with netbooks too. So, and then I also use GTK Record My Desktop with Musix, which is a multimedia Linux Debian based operating system. That's really great. So I like this little program. It seems to be pretty easy. Okay, here are the basic steps. I'm going to go through these also using screenshots. Now, normally if I was demonstrating an application like a paint program or an animation program, I would be demonstrating the actual application as I was doing this, but in this case I can't because I'm recording it already with the application. So it's like doing it on top of itself. I don't know. Can't do it. Okay, the steps. First you open the application. Then you click on Save As in the window and name it whatever you want. Suggestion for, you know, video1.ogv. Now, .ogv is the video format that this program uses. Okay, then go ahead and open your slideshow, position your apps, get ready to go. And then in the upper right-hand corner of the screen, there's a red dot that is, you know, sort of a universal symbol for record. So you click on the red dot, and then it starts recording. And then if you were doing a slideshow, you'd start the slideshow going, or go to the page, or position that you're discussing. Anyway, then go ahead and narrate your work, like I'm doing right now, with an internal or external microphone. I'm using an external microphone right now because the sound is a little bit better. But on this netbook, I do have an internal microphone, and that works too. So it's just whatever you have. And narrate it as you show your slideshow, demonstrate your applications. And when you're finished, there is a little white square where the red dot used to be, and you click on the white square. And as soon as you do that, it comes up to a screen, and it says, there's a yellow bar going across the screen, and it says, wait, make sure you don't touch anything, close anything, shut off your computer, because the video is being encoded. And if you interrupt it, you can't retrieve it. So it is very important that you wait for that spot. Okay, let's look at the screenshots. Okay, on my screen, this is a page of local applications. Jolly Cloud is similar to I like it better, in fact, but it's very similar to an iPad type of configuration where it's got the applications that are actually web-based. And this is a page of applications that are, I guess there's a couple of web-based ones here too, but most of these are installed on my computer. And you can see, there it is, GTK Record My Desktop. Okay, and then this is the screen that comes up. And you see up here the red dot that we'll click on when we want to start recording. And down here, now if you wanted to record just a certain part of the screen, you could choose that up here in this corner, but I don't do anything with it because I want it to record everything. So you click on Save As, and then you're going to give your video a name and make sure that it is .ogv. Click Save, and then, okay, so then you do your recording. You know, do what you want to record, blah, 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 blah. And this is the screen that comes after you stop. And it says, please wait while your recording is being encoded. Warning, if you press cancel or close this window, the process cannot be resumed. So, and then you can cancel it if you, like, this is the second time I'm doing this one because I started and I found an error, so I'm doing it over again. But anyway, this yellow bar here has to get all the way over to the end. And then this window will disappear and it'll be back to the original window. And then you know you're done. Okay, and you've made your video at that point. Now, the thing about OGV, now that video format will play on this computer, but I want to upload it to YouTube. And YouTube has just become very wonderful about using, they use most formats. However, when I have tried to upload this OGV format, it gives me an error. So, okay, no problem. I have a little program that allows me to convert it to an FLV. So, and I don't know how to pronounce this. It's a PITIVI video editor. Is that PITV or is it PITIVI or I don't know. I don't know what it is. PITV video editor, whatever it is. Okay. So this once again is just a list of instructions, and then I'll show you screenshots. You open the application, then you're going to add the video1.ogv, whatever you named it, as a clip. You drag the clip to the timeline. You're going to click on the render button, choose a file name, click on modify, and there's a section that says export to container. You choose FLV format, and then once it's done rendering, it's ready, and you can upload it to YouTube. So once again here, this is my window, this is my screenshot in Jolie Cloud, and right here is the PITV video editor that I open. Okay, so this is what it looks like when you first open it, and up here there's a button that says import clips. That's what we're going to do next. Okay, and so I chose my OGV file. And the next thing I'm going to do is you just click on that icon right there on that little picture, and you drag it down into the timeline. See? And one thing you want to make sure is that you have this right at the beginning. That's not hard to do, though, because you just drag it straight down, and then it appears. I mean, that's all there is to that. And we're just converting it. We're not... I have another program that I use for editing. I use a program called Cinlera. I'm sure it's possible to edit with this, but Cinlera is a program to use for editing. So, okay, at this point, though, this is just the way I want it, so I'm going to render it. To change it to the other format, it up here is the button where you click on Render Project, and it comes up to this window, Render Project. First thing we're going to do is choose name the file. So where it says Output File, choose File. So you click on that button, come to this window, and once again you're just giving it a name like you did before when you clicked on Save As and named it OGV in the first application. Now with this program we are going to name it something.flv. Okay, and you click OK, and then you are going to, you have to change, let's go back. I'm just going to look at this. The next thing is to click this button that says Modify, okay, because we want a different format from what the default is. So going a couple steps ahead back to where we were, Okay, so the top line, you can leave it as PAL and CD for the audio output. Just leave that like it is. But down here, export to container. That is the one we're going to change. Now, the AUG format is actually a format that I use when I'm rendering in Synlera. But I decided that I like, in this particular little program, I like to use FLV. which is, you know, that's like the Flash format, or it's I don't know, Flash, there's a couple, it's SWF and FLV, those are Flash related formats, okay, but that just happens to be what I like here. So I have chosen that under the section where it says container, and it automatically changes the audio and video codecs, and we just leave those as they are. Click OK, then you come up to this screen, and then once again you have to click on render once you're there. But when you clicked on render, then you see this little line going across, and here it says 31 seconds left. It's a very short video, but you just let it go. And when it's finished, it's done. Okay, and you are ready to upload to YouTube. Now, this is my particular YouTube page. I call myself Old Music Teacher Chick. You know, it's YouTube. You gotta have a little fun, you know. And I am going to just click on up here at the top of the screen. You see where it says upload. I'll click on that, and then it comes up to this window, and it says upload video, so I click on that. And then here you come to where it's opening the files on my local computer, on my computer, and I'm choosing the FLV file for the video that I just created using GTK Record My Desktop. And, you know, there you go. You've uploaded a YouTube video. Back here, I didn't go over this. I guess I didn't do a screenshot of that, but there is a place where you can enter. Once you've done this and you click open, it comes to a screen where it's uploading your file, and you can enter all this information about it, and, you know, do you want it to make it public, or do you want it to be private? What kind of keywords do you want to use, etc., etc.? It's pretty self-explanatory. You'll see it there, and you go, oh, okay, I better fill these out. Click save. Anyway, you have a YouTube video, and it's really pretty easy. Now, this very last page here, if you're wondering how to install GTK Record My Desktop and PitTV Video Editor, what I would suggest for most of you out there is that you would go and install JolieCloud first, which is an operating system that can sit right next to Windows. Probably most of you have Windows. Now, if you have a Mac, of course, if you have Linux, you can already get all of this stuff, okay? You know, you just go to Synaptic or Add Applications, and you can get these applications. They're common Linux applications, GTK Record My Desktop, PitTV Video Editor, okay? But if you have Windows, put JolieCloud. JolieCloud is so easy to install. Now, that needs to be probably another instructional video, but the JolieCloud.com website, you know, if you do a search for how to install JolieCloud and keep Windows, it's just so easy. You know, you click on some little installation button, it's right in Windows. It's so slick, and it seems really foolproof to me. I don't know how you could screw it up, but it is really easy. And what it will do is when your computer boots, then you can choose Windows or JolieCloud. Okay, and it will not touch or alter Windows at all. But then what you have done is you have opened yourself up to a whole world of free applications with Jolie. Another thing is if you have a netbook and you have Windows, especially this one had XP on it, and it's still there, you know, next to Jolie Cloud, but it was horrible. There's just no comparison with Jolie Cloud. I mean, it's all the millions of viruses you get with Windows, but also, you know, the Windows didn't fit this screen right. So, anyway, Jolie Cloud, if you put that on your computer, you know, there are just hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of free applications that you can have and use. Okay. That's it.